This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Meghalaya, Mi Li, or US, Mi Li, Mia Li, is a state in northeast India. The name means the abode of clouds. In Sanskrit, the population of Meghalaya as of 2014 is estimated to be 3,211,474. Meghalaya covers an area of approximately 22,430 square kilometers, with a length to breadth ratio of about 3 to 1. The state is bounded to the south by the Bangladeshi divisions of Mymessing and Sylhet, to the west by the Bangladeshi division of Rangpur, and to the east by India's state of Assam. The capital of Meghalaya is Shillong. During the British occupation of India, foreign British imperialist authorities nicknamed it the Scotland of the East. Meghalaya was previously part of Assam, but on 21 January 1972, the districts of Khasi, Garo and Jaintia Hills became the new state of Meghalaya. English is the official language of Meghalaya. The other principal languages spoken include Khasi, Panar and Garo. Unlike many Indian states, Meghalaya has historically followed a matrilineal system where the lineage and inheritance are traced through women. The youngest daughter inherits all wealth and she also takes care of her parents. The state is the wettest region of India, recording an average of 12,000 birds and plants. Meghalaya has predominantly an agrarian economy with a significant commercial forestry industry. The important crops are potatoes, rice, maize, pineapples, bananas, papayas, spices, etc. The service sector is made up of real estate and insurance companies. Meghalaya's gross state domestic product for 2012 was estimated at 16,173 crore rupees, $24 United States dollars. 6. Education. 7. Government and politics. 71. State government. 72. Local self-government. 8. Economy. 81. Agriculture. 82. Industry. 83. Electricity infrastructure. 84. Education infrastructure. 85. Health infrastructure. 9. Urban areas. 91. New proposal for urban areas. 10. Culture and society. 101. Social institutions. 102. Traditional political institutions. 103. Festivals. 104. Spirituality. 11. Transport. 111 Road network. 112 Railway. 113 Aviation. 12 Tourism. 13 Major issues. 131 Illegal immigration. 132 Violence. 133 Political instability. 134 Jhum farming. 14 Media. 15 See also. 16 References. 17 Bibliography. 18 External links. History. Ancient Meghalaya, along with neighboring Indian states, have been of archaeological interest. People have lived here since Neolithic era. Neolithic sites discovered so far are located in areas of high elevation such as in Khasi Hills, Garo Hills and neighboring states. Here Neolithic style Jhum or shifting cultivation is practiced even today. The highland plateaus fed by abundant rains provided safety from floods and a rich soil. The importance of Meghalaya as its possible role in human history through domestication of rice. One of the competing theories for the origin of rice is from Ian Glover, who states, India is the center of greatest diversity of domesticated rice with over 20,000 identified species, and Northeast India is the most favorable single area of the origin of domesticated rice. The limited archaeology done in the hills of Meghalaya suggest human settlement since ancient times. Modern history. Meghalaya was formed by carving out two districts from the state of Assam, the United Khasi Hills and Jaintia Hills, and the Garo Hills on 21 January 1972 before attaining full statehood. Meghalaya was given semi-autonomous status in 1970. The Khasi, Garo, and Jaintia tribes had their own kingdoms until they came under British administration in the 19th century. Later, the British incorporated Meghalaya into Assam in 1835. The region enjoyed semi-independent status by virtue of a treaty relationship with the British Crown when Bengal was partitioned on 16 October 1905 by Lord Curzon. Meghalaya became a part of the new province of Eastern Bengal and Assam. However, when the partition was reversed in 1912, Meghalaya became a part of the province of Assam on 3 January 1921 in pursuance of Section 52A of the Government of India Act of 1919. The Governor General in Council declared the areas now in Meghalaya, other than the Khasi states, as backward tracts. Subsequently, the British administration enacted the Government of India Act of 1935, which regrouped the backward tracts into two categories, excluded and partially excluded areas at the time of Indian independence in 1947. Present-day Meghalaya constituted two districts of Assam and enjoyed limited autonomy within the state of Assam. Assam-A movement for a separate hill state began in 1960. The Assam Reorganization Meghalaya Act of 1969 accorded an autonomous status to the state of Meghalaya. The act came into effect on 2 April 1970, and an autonomous state of Meghalaya was born out of Assam. The autonomous state had a 37-member legislature in accordance with the 6th schedule to the Indian Constitution in 1971. The parliament passed the Northeastern Areas Reorganization Act, 1971, which conferred full statehood on the autonomous state of Meghalaya. Meghalaya attained statehood on 21 January 1972, with a legislative assembly of its own geography. Meghalaya is mountainous, the most rain-soaked state of India. The word Meghalaya means, abode of the clouds, above is late Masang landscape wrapped in fog. Meghalaya is one of the seven sister states of Northeast India. The state of Meghalaya is mountainous, with stretches of valley and highland plateaus, and it is geologically rich. It consists mainly of Archean rock formations. These rock formations contain rich deposits of valuable minerals like coal, limestone, uranium and sillimanite. Meghalaya has many rivers. Most of these are rain-fed and seasonal. The important rivers in the Garo Hills region are Dering, Sonda, Bandra, Bogai, Daring, Simsang, Natai and the Bupai in the central and eastern sections of the plateau. The important rivers are Khri, Daiguru, Umiam, Kinchi Jadukata, Mapa, Umiam or Barapani, Umgad and Mintu in the southern Khasi Hills region. These rivers have created deep gorges and several beautiful waterfalls. Agriculture farms in Meghalaya above are on hilly terrain. The elevation of the plateau ranges between 150. Region with lower elevations experiences high temperatures for most of the year. The Shillong area, with the highest elevations, experiences generally low temperatures. The maximum temperature in this region rarely goes beyond 28. Protected from any exploitation, these sacred groves harbor many rare plant and animal species. The Nokrek Biosphere Reserve in the West Garo Hills and the Balfakram National Park in the South Garo Hills are considered to be the most biodiversity-rich sites in Meghalaya. In addition, Meghalaya has three wildlife sanctuaries. These are the Nongkilam Wildlife Sanctuary, the Seju Sanctuary and the Bogmara Sanctuary, which is also the home of the insect-eating pitcher plant Nepenthes khasiana. Due to diverse climatic and topographic conditions, Meghalayan forests support a vast floral diversity, including a large variety of parasites, epiphytes, succulent plants and shrubs. Two of the most important tree varieties are Sharia robusta sal tree and Tectona grandis teak. Meghalaya is also the home to a large variety of fruits, vegetables, spices and medicinal plants. Meghalaya is also famous for its large variety of orchids. Nation's rarest bat species, the Hulak gibbon, is found in all districts of Meghalaya. Common reptiles in Meghalaya are lizards, crocodiles and tortoises. Meghalaya also has a number of snakes, including the python, copperhead, green tree racer, Indian cobra, king cobra, coral snake and vipers. Meghalaya's forests host 660 species of birds, many of which are endemic to Himalayan foothills, Tibet and Southeast Asia. Of the birds found in Meghalaya forests, 34 are on worldwide threatened species list and 9 are on critically endangered list. Prominent birds spotted in Meghalaya include those from the families of Phasianidae, Anatidae, Podocypedidae, Ciconiidae, Threscyornithidae, Ardeidae, Pelicanidae, Phallocrocoracidae, Onhingidae, Falconidae, Accipitridae, Otididae, Rallidae, Heliornithidae, Gruidae, Ternicidae, Barinidae, Caradriidae, Glareolidae, Scolopacidae, Jacanidae, Columbidae, Cetacidae, Cuculidae, Strigidae, Caprimulgidae, Apodidae, Alcidinidae, Bucerotidae, Ramphastidae, Pisidae, Campophagidae, Dacuridae, Corvidae, Hirundinidae, Cysticolidae, Pycnonotidae, Sylviidae, Tamaliidae, Cytidae, Sternidae, Turtidae, Nectariniidae and Mushacapidae. Each of these families have many species. The Great Indian Hornbill is the largest bird in Meghalaya. Other regional birds found include the grey peacock pheasant, the large Indian parakeet, the common green pigeon and the blue jay. Meghalaya is also home to over 250 species of butterflies, nearly a quarter of all butterfly species found in India. Demographics. Population growth. 1991 1,775,329%, 2001 2,319,306%, 2011 2,964,007,278%. Source: Census of India. Ethnic groups: Khasi 47%, Garo 275%, Bengali 17%, Nepali 826%, Kok 18%, Jaintia 25%. Hajong, 28% Kuki, 048% Sheikh, 03% Other, 1036% Tribal people make up the majority of Meghalaya's population. The Khasis are the largest group, followed by the Garos, then the Jainches. These were among those known to the British as hill tribes. Other groups include the Koch, the Biats of Saipung constituency and Jowai, the related Rajabongshi, the Boro, Hajong, Dimasa, Kuki, Hmar, Lakar, Karbi, Raba and Nepali. Meghalaya recorded the highest decennial population growth of 2,782% among all the seven northeastern states. As per the Provisional Report of Census 2011, the population of Meghalaya as of 2011 has been estimated at 2,964,007, of which females comprise 1,492,668 and males 1,471,339. As per the Census of India 2011, the sex ratio in the state was 986 females per 1,000 males, which was far higher than the national average of 940. The urban female sex ratio of 985 was higher than the rural sex ratio of 972. Religion: the Cathedral of Mary Help of Christians in Shillong, Meghalaya. Religion in Meghalaya 2011. Raba 28,153 to 9,460% Hindu, Makir 11,399 to 52% Christian and 30% Hindu, and Kuki 10,085 to 73% Christian and 26% Hindu. Conversion from indigenous to Christianity began in the 19th century under the British era in 1830s. American Baptist Foreign Missionary Society had become active in Northeast to convert indigenous tribes to Christianity later. They were offered to expand and reach into Cherrapunji Meghalaya, but they lacked the resources to do so and declined. Welsh Presbyterian Mission took the offer and they began work at the Cherrapunji Mission Field by early 1900s. Other Protestant sects of Christianity were active in Meghalaya. The outbreak of world wars forced the preachers to return home to Europe and America. It is during this period that Catholicism took root in Meghalaya and neighbouring region in 20th century. Union Christian College started operations at Barapani, Shillong. Currently, Presbyterians and Catholics are two most common Christian sects found in Meghalaya languages. Languages of Meghalaya in 2001. People of the Jaintia Hills. The language is related to the Khasi language. The Pnar, or Jaintia, language is spoken, along with Khasi, by the Kainriam, Bhoi, Pnar and War tribal groups. Another example is the Biat language spoken by many people of the Saipung constituency. Jaintia Hills. The language is closely related to the Biat of Dima Haseo. Assam Nepali is found in almost all parts of the state. English is spoken as a common language across the diverse ethnic and demographic groups in urban centers. Most of the people can speak English. Rural residents vary in their ability. Languages in Meghalaya. Language family share: Khasi Austroasiatic 4,705%, Garo Tibeto Burman 3,141%, Bengali Indo-Aryan 79%, Nepali Indo-Aryan 224%, Hindi Indo-Aryan 21%, Marathi Indo-Aryan 167%, Assamese Indo-Aryan 158%, Maram Tibeto Burman languages 153%, Hajong Indo-Aryan 106%, Raba Tibeto Burman languages 097%, Koch Tibeto Burman languages 090%. Districts: an aerial view of the state capital. Shillong, Meghalaya currently has 11 districts: Jaintia Hills, West Jaintia Hills, Jowai, East Jaintia Hills, Cleariat, Khasi Hills Division, East Khasi Hills, Shillong, West Khasi Hills, Nonstuan, South West Khasi Hills, Makarwit. Re Bhoi Nongpo Garo Hills Division, North Garo Hills, Risabelpara East Garo Hills, Williamnagar South Garo Hills, Bagmara West Garo Hills, Tura South West Garo Hills, Ampati. The Jaintia Hills District was created on 22 February 1972. It has a total geographical area of 3,819 square kilometres, 1,475. The district was 192,795 in the 2001 census. The district headquarters is at Nongpo. It has a hilly terrain, and a large part of the area is covered with forests. The Re Bhoi district is famous for its pineapples and is the largest producer of pineapples in the state. The West Khasi Hills district is the largest district in the state with a geographical area of 5,247 square kilometers, 2,026. The district headquarters are at Baghmara as of 2012. There are 11 districts, 16 towns, and an estimated 6,026 villages in Meghalaya. Education. Main article: Education in Meghalaya. Indian Institute of Management, Shillong. Meghalaya schools are run by the state government or by private organizations, including religious institutions. Instruction is only in English. Other Indian languages like Assamese, Bengali, Hindi, Garo, Khasi, Mizo, Nepali. Universities. University of Science and Technology, Meghalaya. USTM, Meghalaya. Northeastern Hill University, NEHU, Shillong. CMJ University, Shillong. Mahatma Gandhi University, Nongpo, Meghalaya. Martin Luther Christian University, Meghalaya. The Institute of Chartered Financial Analysts of India University, Meghalaya. Techno Global University, Meghalaya. University of Technology and Management, Meghalaya. William Carey University, Meghalaya. Colleges: St. Edmund's College, Shillong. St. Anthony's College, Shillong. Lady Keen College, Shillong. St. Mary's College, Shillong. Union Christian College, Barapani. Shillong College, Shillong. Tura Govt College, Tura. Sankardev College, Shillong. College of Teacher Education PGT, Shillong. Synod College, Shillong. Kiang Nongba Govt College, Jowai Sang Khasi College, Shillong. Nonstuan College, Nonstuan Achung Rangmanpa College, Mahendraganj Re Bhoi College, Nongpo Sora College, Cherrapunji. Shillong Commerce College, Shillong. Don Bosco College, Tura Women's College, Shillong. Phokan Memorial College, Dalu, W. Garo Hills. Tikrakila College, Tikrakila. W. Garo Hills. Some institutes like Indian Institute of Management, Shillong, Regional Institute of Science and Technology, Northeastern Indira Gandhi Regional Institute of Health and Medical Sciences, National Institute of Technology, Meghalaya, Indian Institute of Professional Studies, National Institute of Fashion Technology are also present. Government and Politics. Main Articles: Government of Meghalaya and Meghalaya Legislative Assembly. State Government. The Meghalaya Legislative Assembly has 60 members at present. Meghalaya has two representatives in the Lok Sabha, one each from Shillong and Tura. It also has one representative in the Rajya Sabha. Since the creation of the state, the Guwahati High Court has jurisdiction in Meghalaya. A circuit bench of the Guwahati High Court has been functioning at Shillong since 1974. However, recently in March 2013, the Shillong High Court was separated from the Guwahati High Court, and now the state has its own High Court. Local self-government. In order to provide local self-governance machinery to the rural population of the country, provisions were made in the Constitution of India, and accordingly the Panchayati Raj institutions were set up. However, on account of the distinct customs and traditions prevailing in Northeast region, it was felt necessary to have a separate political and administrative structure in the region. Some of the tribal communities in the region had their own traditional political systems, and it was felt that Panchayati Raj institutions may come into conflict with these traditional systems. The sixth schedule was appended to the Constitution on the recommendations of a subcommittee formed under the leadership of Gopinath Bordoloi, and the Constitution of Autonomous District Councils ADCs is provided in certain rural areas of the Northeast, including areas in Meghalaya. Following are the ADCs in Meghalaya: Khasi Hills Autonomous District Council, Garo Hills Autonomous District Council, and Jaintia Hills Autonomous District Council. Economy. Meghalaya is predominantly an agrarian economy. Agriculture and allied activities engage nearly two-thirds of the total workforce in Meghalaya. However, the contribution of this sector to the state's NSDP is only about one-third. Agriculture in the state is characterized by low productivity and unsustainable farm practices. Despite the large percentage of population engaged in agriculture, the state imports food from other Indian states. Infrastructural constraints have also prevented the economy of the state from creating high-income jobs at a pace commensurate with that of the rest of India. Meghalaya's gross state domestic product for 2012 was estimated at 16,173 crore rupees, 24 United States dollars. Line. Agriculture. Tea plantation. Agriculture in Meghalaya. India on the way to Shillong. Meghalaya is basically an agricultural state, with about 80% of its population depending entirely on agriculture for their livelihood. Nearly 10% of the geographical area of Meghalaya is under cultivation. Agriculture in the state is characterized by limited use of modern techniques, low yields, and low productivity as a result. Despite the vast majority of the population being engaged in agriculture, the contribution of agricultural production to the state's GDP is low, and most of the population engaged in agriculture remain poor. A portion of the cultivated area is under the traditional shifting agriculture known locally as jhum cultivation. Meghalaya produced 230,000 tons of food grains in 2001. Rice is the dominant food grain crop, accounting for over 80% of the food grain production in the state. Other important food grain crops are maize, wheat, and a few other cereals and pulses. Besides these, potato, ginger, turmeric, black pepper, areca nut, tezpata, betelvine, short staple cotton, jute, mesta, mustard, and rapeseed, etc., are some of the important cash crops. Besides the major food crops of rice and maize, the state is renowned for its horticultural crops like orange, lemon, pineapple, guava, lychee, banana, jackfruits, and fruits such as plum, pear, and peach. Agriculture in Kukan, Meghalaya. Grains and staples production covers about 60% of the land area dedicated to crops. With the introduction of different crops of high-yielding varieties in the mid-1970s, remarkable increase in food grain production has been made. A major breakthrough was achieved when high-yielding varieties of paddy such as Missouri, Pankaj IR8, RCPL, and other improved varieties series, especially IR36, which is suitable for Rabi season, allowing three crops to be grown every year. Another milestone was reached when Mega I and Mega II, which are cold-tolerant rice varieties developed by the ICAR Northeast region at Umroy near Shillong, was released in 1991-92 for the higher altitude regions where there was no high-yielding rice varieties earlier. Today the state can claim that about 42% area under paddy have been covered with high-yielding varieties with the average productivity of 2,300. Such as cotton, jute, and mesta are among the only cash crops in Meghalaya. Grown in Garo Hills, these have been losing popularity in recent years as indicated by their declining yield and area under cultivation. Climatic conditions in Meghalaya permit a large variety of horticulture crops including fruits, vegetables, flowers, spices, mushrooms, and medicinal plants. These are considered to be higher value crops, but home food security concerns have prevented farmers at large from embracing them. The important fruits grown include citrus fruits, pineapples, papayas, and bananas. In addition to this, a large variety of vegetables are grown in the state, including cauliflower, cabbages, and radishes. Areca nut plantations can be seen all over the state, especially around the road from Guwahati to Shillong. Other plantation crops like tea, coffee, and cashews have been introduced lately and are becoming popular. A large variety of spices, flowers, medicinal plants, and mushrooms are grown in the state. Industry view of MCL cement plant, Thang Sky, P.O. Lum Shnong, Jainsha Hills. Meghalaya has a rich base of natural resources. These include minerals such as coal, limestone, sillimanite, kaolin, and granite, among others. Meghalaya has a large forest cover, rich biodiversity, and numerous water bodies. The low level of industrialization and the relatively poor infrastructure base acts as an impediment to the exploitation of these natural resources in the interest of the state's economy. In recent years, two large cement manufacturing plants with production capacity more than 900 MTD have come up in Jainsha Hills district, and several more are in pipeline to use the rich deposit of very high quality limestone available in this district. Electricity infrastructure. Meghalaya has abundant but undeveloped hydroelectric resources. Above is Maflong Hydroelectric Dam Reservoir. Meghalaya, with its high mountains, deep gorges, and abundant rains, has a large, unused hydroelectric potential. The assessed generation capacity exceeds 3,000 megawatts. The current installed capacity in the state is 185 megawatts, but the state itself consumes 610 megawatts. In other words, it imports electricity. The economic growth of the state suggests rising demand for electricity. The state has the potential to export net hydroelectric generated electricity and earn income for its internal development plans. The state also has large deposits of coal, thus being a candidate for thermal power plants. Several projects are under works. The proposed Garo Hills thermal project at Nongalbibra is expected to generate an additional 751 megawatts of power. There is a proposal for setting up a 250 megawatts thermal power plant in West Khasi Hills. The state government aims to increase its power generation output by about 2,000 to 2,500 megawatts, of which 700 to 980 megawatts will be thermal-based, while 1,400 to 1,520 megawatts will be hydroelectricity. The state government has outlined a cost-shared public-private partnership model to accelerate private sector investments in its power sector. The generation, transmission, transformation, and distribution of electricity is entrusted to the Meghalaya Energy Corporation Limited, which was constituted under the Electricity Supply Act, 1948. At present there are 5 Heidel power stations and 1 mini Heidel, including Umium Heidel Project, Umtru Heidel Project, Mintu Leshka I Heidel Project and the Sunapani Micro Heidel SESU Project for the 12th Five-Year Plan of India. There is a proposal to set up more Heidel power projects in the state: Kinshi 450 MW, UMNG I-154 MW, Umium UMTRU V36 MW, Ganal 25 MW, Mafu 120 MW, Nangkole 120 MW, Nangna 50 MW, Rangma 65 MW, Umgat 260 MW, Umduna 57 MW, Mintu Leshka 260 MW, Selam 170 MW and Mablai 140 MW. Of these, JP Group has committed itself to building the Kinshi and Umgat projects in Khasi Hills Education Infrastructure, St. Edmund's School, Shillong. Main article: Education in Meghalaya. Meghalaya has a literacy rate of 6,256 as per the 2001 census and is the 27th most literate state in India. This increased to 755 in 2011. As of 2006, the state had 5,851 primary schools, 1759 middle schools, and 655 higher secondary schools respectively. In 2008, 518,000 students were enrolled in its primary schools, and 232,000 in upper primary schools. The state monitors its school for quality, access, infrastructure and teachers training. Institution for higher studies like Indian Institute of Management, the University of Technology and Management which is in Shillong, is the first Indian university to introduce cloud computing engineering as a field of study, in collaboration with IBM and the University of Petroleum and Energy Studies. Shillong is one of the top-ranked management institutes in the country. Health infrastructure: the state has 13 state government dispensaries, 22 community health centers, 93 primary health centers, 408 sub-centers. There were 378 doctors, 81 pharmacists, 337 staff nurses and 77 lab technicians as of 2012. A special program has been launched by the state government for the treatment of tuberculosis, leprosy, cancer and mental diseases. Though there has been a steady decline in the death rate, improvement in life expectancy and an increase in health infrastructure, about 423% of the state's population is still uncovered by health care. According to the status paper prepared by the health department, there are numerous hospitals being set up, both private and government. Some of them are Civil Hospital, Ganesh Das Hospital, KJP Synod Hospital, NEIGRIHMS, North Eastern Institute of Ayurveda, NEIAH, RP Chest Hospital, Woodland Hospital, Nazareth Hospital, Christian Hospital, etc. Urban areas: municipalities, Shillong, Tura, Jowai Municipal Boards, Williamnagar, Risabelpara, Bagmara Cantonment Board, Shillong Cantonment, Umroy Town Committees, Nongtuan, Nongpo, Merung Census Towns, Mao Lai, Madanarting, Nongthimai, Nongminsong, Pinthorumkra, Sora, Cherrapunji, Pinersla Minor Towns, Cleariat, Makarwat, Ampati areas under Shillong Urban Agglomeration: Shillong, Shillong Cantonment, Umroy, Mao Lai, Madanarting, Nongthimai, Nongminsong, Pinthorumkra. New proposal for urban areas: municipal corporations, 1 Shillong including Shillong Cantonment, Umroy, Mao Lai, Madanarting, Nongthimai, Nongminsong, Pinthorumkra municipalities, 2 Tura, Jowai Municipal Boards, 9 Williamnagar, Risabelpara, Bagmara, Nongtuan, Nongpo, Cleariat, Makarwat, Ampati, Merung Town Committees, 2 Sora, Cherrapunji, Pinersla. Culture and society: the main tribes in Meghalaya are the Khasis, the Garos, and the Jainches. Each tribe has its own culture, traditions, dress and language. Social institutions: Khasi girls, the majority of population and the major tribal groups in Meghalaya, follow a matrilineal system where lineage and inheritance are traced through women. The youngest daughter inherits all the property and she is the caretaker of aged parents and any unmarried siblings in some cases, such as when there is no daughter in the family or other reasons. The parents may nominate another girl, such as a daughter-in-law, as the heir of house and all other property they may own. The Khasi and Jaintia tribesmen follow the traditional matrilineal norm, wherein the Kun Katdu or the youngest daughter inherits all the property and responsibilities for the family. However, the male line, particularly the mother's brother, may indirectly control the ancestral property, since he may be involved in important decisions relating to property, including its sale and disposal. In case a family has no daughters, the Khasi and Jaintia, also called Sinteng, have the custom of ia rap iing, where the family adopts a girl from another family, perform religious ceremonies with the community, and she then becomes ka tri iing head of the house in the Garo lineage system. The youngest daughter inherits the family property by default, unless another daughter is so named by the parents. She then becomes designated as Nokna, meaning for the house or home. If there are no daughters, a chosen daughter-in-law Bohari or an adopted child Duragata comes to stay in the house and inherit the property. Meghalaya has one of the world's largest surviving matrilineal cultures, traditional political institutions. All the three major ethnic tribal groups, namely, the Khasis, Jainches and the Garos, also have their own traditional political institutions that have existed for hundreds of years. These political institutions were fairly well developed and functioned at various tiers, such as the village level, clan level and state level. In the traditional political system of the Khasis, each clan had its own council known as the Dorbar Kur, which was presided over by the clan headman. The council or the Dorbar managed the internal affairs of the clan. Similarly, every village had a local assembly known as the Dorbar Shnong, i.e. village Durbar or council, which was presided over by the village headman. The inter-village issues were dealt with through a political unit comprising adjacent Khasi villages. The local political units were known as the raids, under by the supreme political authority known as the Saimship. The Saimship was the congregation of several raids and was headed an elected chief known as the Syiem or Seem. The king, the Seem, ruled the Khasi state through an elected state assembly, known as the Durbar Hema. The Seem also had his Mantris, ministers whose counsel he would use in exercising executive responsibilities. Taxes were called Pinsik, and tolls were called Krong, the latter being the primary source of state income in early 20th century. Raja Dakor Singh was the Seem of Khymer Meghalaya. Festival local calendar month, Vedic calendar month, Gregorian calendar month, Denbilja Polgan Fal Gun February Asaroka Chuit Kshetra March A Galmaka Pesak Vaisaka April Miyamua Asala Sharha June Rongchugala Bado Badra August Ahaya Asan Ashwin September Wangala Gate Kartika October Christmas Posi Pasha December. The Jainches also had a three-tier political system somewhat similar to the Khasis, including the raids and the Syiem. The raids were headed by Dolwa, who were responsible for performing the executive and ceremonial functions at the raid level. At the lowest level were the village headmen. Each administrative tier had its own elected councils or durbars. In the traditional political system of the Garos, a group of Garo villages comprised the A-King. The A-King functioned under the supervision of the Nakmas, which was perhaps the only political and administrative authority in the political institution of the Garos. The Nakma performed both judicial and legislative functions. The Nakmas also congregated to address intra king issues. There were no well-organized councils or durbars among the Garos. Citation needed. Festivals. Dance of Meghalaya. Khasi's dance is central to the culture of Khasi life, and a part of the rites of passage. Dances are performed in Shnong village, a raid group of villages, and a Hema conglomeration of raids. Some festivals includes Ka Shad Suk Mainsiam, Ka Pom Blang Nongkrim, Ka Shad Shingviong Thanjop, Ka Shad Kinjo Kaskane, Ka Bam Kana Shnong, Umsan Nongkarai, Shad Bay Sir. Jaincha's festivals of the Jaincha Hills, like others, is integral to the culture of people of Jaincha Hills. It celebrates nature, balance and solidarity among its people. Festivals of Jainches includes Bedingklam, Leo dance, sewing ritual ceremony. Garos for Garos. Festivals sustain their cultural heritage. They were often dedicated to religious events, nature and seasons, as well as community events such as stages of jhum cultivation. The main festivals of Garos are Den Bilsia, Wangala, Rongchu Gala, Mi Amua, Mangona, Grengdik Ba, Jamong Sia, Ya Megapa, Sa Sat Ra Chaka, Ajior Ahawaya, Dor Rada dance, Chambal Masara, Dokrujwa, Saram Chaa, Asay Mania or Tata, which celebrated